Hello and greetings from Iceland, but this is going to be short now since I'm just going to tell you about the latest news from the Reykjanes Peninsula. But it looks as if Mother Nature is up for something again. A level of uncertainty has been declared and the aviation color code was raised to code yellow just now. But it was just shortly after noon today, Saturday, that I noticed this earthquake swarm not so far away from the craters from the 2021 eruption. So I started to be on the lookout. Since we haven't had any serious movements there since the eruption came to an end. And it has always been a possibility that it would start again. So webcams were placed there just a while ago. And this volcano is a sealed volcano that can be building up for decades with long or short intervals. The 2021 eruption was small. And what made me jump up from other projects today was first of all the fact that the first earthquakes occurred between Mount Keilir and the craters from the 2021 eruption, or by the dike that fed that eruption and had its origin by Mount Keilir. And as this grew, I checked out the webcam that I'm linking to, and this is how it looked in a few minutes time-lapse format, but it was raining earlier today, so I don't want to rule out that it had something to do with it. But just before I sat down with this voiceover, I found out that the close-up webcam is up and running again. And it is clear that there is some smoke coming up from there, more than usual. But there is always some smoke coming from there, every now and then. So how to follow up on this from wherever you are? That's next. As usual, the live view shows you only a rough image of what's happening, and the other official app where you can make your own plot minute by minute, hour by hour. It can't keep up since the earthquakes don't appear there until the location and the depth has been confirmed, or the accuracy. And you can also see the accuracy on the other web or here. And when it's up to 99%, that means that it has been overlooked by a human. And then we have this web where we can see the earthquakes appear as they come. And that plot is telling me that the earthquake swarm is moving both ways, to northeast, to Keilir, and southwest, to Geldingadalir. So the epicenter is somewhere between Keilir and Geldingadalir, straight over that magma deck. And there are hundreds of them now, and I have not seen such activity since last year. And the tremors are off the chart as well. So where is this going? And the simple answer is as usual, this will fade out or end with an eruption. And in case of an eruption, most likely nearby the old craters, which has to be good for the town Grindavík, since we were worried for a while about that town. Whole lot of shaking around there just 2 months ago, during the last episode. And if the next episode is taking place here, it's only good news. Unless we get a larger eruption than last year, since lava from Geldingadalir can go all the way into town. Like I mentioned in a recent video that I'm linking to, where I covered the status of the town in details. So the epicenter is around here now, and let's say that an eruption would take place here. That would in fact be worse than the location last year, because the lava from there would take off to the north, not the south like last year. And that's where we have the busiest highway in Iceland, the road between Reykjavík and Keflavík International Airport. But it's too early to go into that now. But I can tell you that I have flown over all possible and impossible locations all around there with a drone. And some of that footage might end up as the before footage. So I'm well prepared now to show you around. So this is what is going on now. You have all the links in the video description, but as for me, I just checked if all my drone batteries were charged and ready, but it takes me around 5 hours to drive from here up north to the south coast, and I've been changing my mind every 5 minutes, all day, should I go or not. But the earthquakes seem to be getting larger, the depth is 3 to 5 kilometers, so this looks as this is moving into a new eruption. But exactly when or how it's gonna play out is of course impossible to say. But being logical, the earthquakes before the 2021 eruption were way worse than we are seeing now. But there is already a dike there that might be open for business. And somehow, it would not surprise me if something would occur during the next days, even hours. But then, this might just be yet another short cycle like we have seen every 4 weeks or so. And every 3 months or so, we see that things get really hectic. And in fact, according to our experts, it's just a matter of time when the next eruption starts on the peninsula. So I am seriously thinking about if I should drop all other projects I have to go south. But I will tell you more about it in the video description as we get into the evening. So I'm gonna finish this voiceover with a simple edit to get it in the air soon. But I suspect that I will end up south tomorrow. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.